Imagine for a moment your pits smelling like nothing. You don't stink after you work out. Your teenager's foot odor doesn't exist. How is this possible? It's Lumi. Challenge Lumi to keep you funk-free for 72 hours. Go to uglytruth.com/Lumi. You can pick your favorite smell, the favorite type of applicator or stick or tube or wipe, and you will be amazed by your non-smelly body. uglytruth.com/Lumi. Welcome to The Ugly Truth. This is episode 521. We're here together.
Miraculous that I got that out.
Producer Deb is camping.
Yay.
And so we are free to be
I'm so jealous. Wait, I know you love Daryl, and I do too, but if I were married as long, well, I am.
Yeah.
I would love it if my husband went away for the weekend.
Oh, God. Stephanie, I have been floating on air all day.
We still like you, D, but I mean, honestly.
He knows that I have been counting down the days. I want him to go. He has not been fishing in over a year.
I know, right?
You know, so they're like,
and I know
okay,
he loves it so bad.
Very much. He went and a lot of their friends are all going, so he met them
nice.
Up there. And, you know, the thing is you have to bring some kind of food item and it's always something completely disgusting and like, not gross disgusting, like so full of junk and calories and whatever.
Oh, yeah. So it's completely indulgent.
Right. So we made dirty tots last
night. And you guys have been fasting. You'll have to tell me about that.
I will tell you about it.
So this must be... Like,
so he made
he's so excited.
So we bought this huge bag of tater tots. He smoked an entire pork shoulder. We bought we bought cheese and all, you know, barbecue sauce and spicy
Yum.
Buffalo sauce. And so we put it all together. It's like a white trash nachos.
It's like a mishmash of.
It's so fucking good.
There's Did you guys eat some?
I've made them before.
Oh, okay.
Not like this, though. This is just huge
this was special.
Portions. And then you put a bunch of fresh jalapenos and chives on it. It's really, really good.
Oh, my God. You must make this for the next time we come over for
I
party.
I will. Absolutely. So he took that because you have to bring something. And then he brought, you know, booze and whiskey or whatever. And then they fish. And then he'll be back tomorrow. It's only one night.
Oh,
it's not staying.
Well, it's not even staying till Sunday.
No. But it's also supposed to snow. And
Ew.
He doesn't really
Oh,
wanna,
that's right.
He doesn't really want to be up there in the snow.
No.
So he's decided he's coming home on Saturday,
yeah.
which is cool. It's fine.
But, hey, it's overnight. It's great.
So, and I'll tell you about this after the show, but our mom came over to visit on Wednesday, and it had been like 10 months since I'd seen her.
Wow.
So she's fully vaccinated. So
oh,
she
good.
Came over, you know, we hugged and we kind of cried a little bit because it had been a
Aww.
Really, really long time.
Yeah, it has been a long time.
And so then she's leaving. And, you know, so we visit, she's leaving, and she's like, so how are you, Daryl, He goes, oh, I'm fine, I'm going fishing, or I'm going camping tomorrow. She's like, oh my God, that's great. I'm like, yeah, isn't that great? And she's like, you don't like camping? I go, mother, no.
Since when? Like
never.
Never.
And she's like, oh, I remember our camping trip, and it reminded me.
I do too. She slept in the car.
It was me and you and Joel, your ex-husband,
right.
Lauren, your daughter, my son, Tyler, and they were like 2 years old.
Yeah, they were
They were
really
little. Mom and then Paula.
And Paula.
That's it.
Yeah.
And there were two tents. I slept in the same tent with Mom and Paula because it was huge.
Yes.
And then you and Joel slept in your own tent.
Right.
And we should have known.
With our daughter, yeah.
We should have known. And okay, so we're saying goodbye to our mom and Mackenzie came over to say hello. And Kenzie's looking confused, like she's never heard this story before. And I said, I should have known. It was up in Tahoe by Emerald Bay. That's
yes.
where we stayed. I said, we should have known the second we got there, it was not going to go well.
Why? What happened?
We pulled in. We have all of our stuff. Mom popped her trunk to her Honda to start unpacking. And we decide, hey, let's go look at the beach before we set up our tents and stuff.
Oh, wait, I do.
We come back and I said, and I shit you not, half the cinnamon rolls had been eaten by some creature. We don't even know what it was and ate it. And there were teeth marks in the styrofoam.
Oh, my God. I remember that.
And I was like, this does not bode well.
Right?
I'm like, what is going on? Now, we had a great sight. It was
did.
Right by a stream. And who knew that animals go to the stream?
Duh. Oh,
well, we found out very quickly. And I said,
yeah.
Do you recall? We're all in bed. It's in the middle of the night. And the biggest possum I've ever seen in my life walked along our tent and brushed your head with its large body, kind of dominant,
And then, and you're awake, you're like, what was that? I'm like, I don't know. I think it was a possum. I'm hoping it was a possum.
And not
I
have a bear, no idea. Right?
And then a pack of coyotes went through I our do campground.
Remember that. We must not have been very smart campers. Like, did we leave food out and stuff?
No, we didn't. We had it all in the cars.
Which I heard that they could still, like, try to get it.
Well, they were... The problem was, and the ranger told us the next day, oh, you're right by the stream. They go there, like, at night.
All night to drink.
That's what they do.
Yeah.
So we idiotically set up our campsite right where probably no one does. That's probably why it was available, you know?
They're like, oh, yeah,
this pack of coyotes comes through. They're yip, 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 yip. There's urine everywhere in the morning.
Oh, my God.
Remember?
Right. I do remember.
But after they came through, I don't know if you remember this, but I was wide awake at this point. It's like 3 o'clock in the morning. And the wind started to blow. It was so windy.
I think I remember Joel being awake, too. Like, he was actually nervous.
So...
And it took a lot to shake him.
I'm laying there going, I really have to pee, and there's no way in hell I'm getting up. What am I going to do?
What am
I going to do? Oh, well, then all of a sudden, the tent whips open, and here's you with your white face and your eyes the size of saucers. You're like, what the hell is going on here? Like, you are terrified. And I'm like, I don't know. And I go, Stephanie, I have to go to the bathroom. And you're like, I'll go with you. Joel!
Oh, God. Thank God. Did I go?
All three of us went together.
Okay. We left our children there?
With mother.
Oh, okay.
She's with our mom.
Well, I remember Paula and mom sleeping in the car. That must have been the next day.
The second day. So we woke up the next morning, and it was like, we were haggard. We were exhausted. We're like, what happened?
Wow, this is fun.
So I told mom, I said, I can't do this. And she's like, I understand. It's okay. So I said, honey, I told Tyler, I'm like, honey, we're going to go home.
You
and he's
left,
like,
huh?
Okay. He opened up the car door and got in his car seat and refused to leave the car until we left. It took me an hour to pack everything up. And he's just like,
oh, my
nope.
God. I can't believe I stayed.
Why did you do that?
Because I was like 20. I don't remember. Ask me if I do it now. Hell no. I mean, if anybody even suggested going camping, I'd be like, no. In fact, we were trying to decide what we wanted to do for like a little weekend or like a mini vacation or whatever. And I had this brilliant idea that we would rent an RV.
And what?
Yeah. I was like, we're going to rent an RV. I'm like, we'll be safe from the pandemic because...
Sure, you'll be on your own.
We'll be on our own. I'm like, but we'll still have a kitchen. We'll be inside. I can't sleep outside. I'm not doing that ever. And I'm like, but we'll... Jeff will still be able to, like, enjoy the outdoors, you know, like... Do a
kid thing. You can stop anywhere. Yeah.
I'm like, we can stay somewhere like by the beach or the ocean or something.
There's tons of KOA campgrounds.
And Jerry's just sitting there. He's like, And I'm like, what? And because I was really like enthusiastic
about it.
I was on the internet. I was Googling everything.
This?
I'm like, okay, I found a place. This thing isn't a piece of crap. It's new. I'm like, it doesn't look like 100 people have been in it.
Right.
And so he looks at Jeff and he's like, you know this that we're never doing this, right? And Jeff's like, why? I think it'd be fun. He goes, your mother will be terrified in 0.2 seconds. I go, we'll be inside an RV. I will not. He goes, Stephanie. He goes, I know you. You will not be able to sleep. You'll be sitting up with a butcher knife in your hand. You'll be thinking any second
wait
someone's
for a
coming
serial
in
to come get you.
He's like, I'm like,
those KOA campers
are
dangerous.
So I was like rolling my eyes. I'm like, yeah, right. Well, then later on, I was thinking about it. I'm like, oh my God, I think he's right. I would be. I'd be like, this little lock is barely anything.
It's like,
anyone can get in.
We're sitting ducks.
Totally.
Exactly.
So I was like, all right, forget it. We're going to a four-star hotel.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
Exactly.
Yeah, because Kevin won't even bark. He's like,
he's
wag
like,
a tail.
Welcome, serial killer, to our home.
Yeah. Well, he's a puppy, so he literally loves everyone. Like, I've
exactly.
never seen him
oh,
bark.
I freaking love that.
So cute.
Anyway, yes. And so I can't think of one camping experience that I have had in my life where I go, that was so fun.
I can't either. Well,
not
the ones
one.
When we were kids were terrible.
Okay, those were terrible. And I've told Daryl about those stories.
God.
I said, yes, our dad took us camping once. We slept outside on a cushion that was meant for the back of the car. And we woke up, we were covered in bites. And then for breakfast, we had hot dogs and grape soda. And
I honestly don't even know what the hell he was thinking. Yeah, we had to like...
Four little girls.
Pee and crap on a hill. There was no water. There was no facilities.
No, it was just on the side of the
road.
They
made us bathe in the river. It was like 20 degrees.
I'm just like, you know, I just knew even then at the ripe age of 9 that this is not going to be my life.
No, I mean, we were on a road and like he just went off the road.
He's like, here we go.
And it was an ice house, and it was freaking freezing.
Yes,
oh,
that
my
was,
God.
And he thought it was hilarious, and I thought it was terrible.
Well, it was terrible.
It was terrible. Anyway, so I hope Producer Dev is having a wonderful time camping.
I do too. Oh, I'm sure he is.
I'm sure he is.
And actually, I mean that sincerely. I hope he's having fun.
Oh, me too.
Well, the thing is that all the people that he goes with and himself, we all have like money now and stuff and like nice things. And so it's not terrible.
The last time they went camping, because they're going to go again in July where it's the man trip. And even my son Tyler's going. I mean, they're all so cool. All man.
I can't wait until Jeff's old enough to go.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I hope they take him.
Absolutely. So the last time they went, which is like 2 years ago now.
Yeah.
They were standing around because they're all about the same age and they look at each other and one guy goes, you think maybe we should rent a cabin next time? Like, do we need tents?
We need a hot tub.
Should we have tents? Like, do we need to do this?
Do they have tents?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I was about to say, I hope they have tents.
They sleep in tents, although Taro bought a sleeping bag to sleep in his car because he doesn't want to sleep in a tent.
Why? Scared or is it too cold?
No, it's cold. Yeah. And he's like, and it's uncomfortable. And I'm like, well, no shit.
Well, and he has like a badass truck.
Last time we went camping, we had a blow up mattress and it deflates because it's cold.
I know, right?
And I'm like, why am I laying on the dirt?
No,
At 4 o'clock in the morning. I hated it.
I am never camping again, honestly.
It's not my fave.
Yeah.
It's not even on the top.
I mean, I kind of like being in the woods and stuff, but I mean, I think I can do like half day trips now.
I told him
a full day.
I said, if you want to do fishing and you want to do the whole getting up at the crack of dawn and all that stuff, just let's find a cabin.
Yeah,
and then
I'll
be happy with the cabin and you can go.
I can have my coffee and sit by the fire while you get up at the crack and go freeze your ass off.
Do you know what he told me? That when they went fishing a couple of years ago, when they were doing the tent fishing, they were in the middle of nowhere and he had to take a shit.
Great.
And I'm like, okay. And he's like, so I broke into a cabin that we found and used their bathroom.
Oh my God.
I'm like,
God.
Was anybody in, like, were there, did it seem like there were presents? Like they were maybe just not home for
lunch? Like, are you a burglar?
He goes, no, they were definitely not. It was definitely closed up. He goes, but the door was open. So I went in and I'm like, what? I'm like, who are you? That is not.
That's desperation.
Yes. And he goes, and I used it. And I'm like, are you proud? He's like, I didn't care. I just did not care.
That's like, so out of character for him.
That's what I said. It's like one of the weirdest things he's ever done.
It's like, you rebel.
Like I was telling someone, the other only other weird thing, and I don't remember who, I was telling Greg, my hairdresser, we were talking about how he got way too drunk on his birthday.
Oh,
and
yes.
And he was telling me
about
the story.
Which was very recently, right?
Yeah, so he was telling me about the story. And I said, he goes, it was just so weird because I normally don't pass out in my clothes. And like, that's
oh,
not
right,
me.
Right, right,
I
right.
don't do that. And I'm like, yeah. Well, you know, it happens.
Right.
And I said, the only time I've seen Daryl act out of character when he's intoxicated was we were up in Reno and I think it was his dad's birthday.
Yeah.
And he had gotten incredibly hammered, like incredibly hammered. Uh-huh. And we went back to a casino to party with his dad and some of their friends.
Oh, Lord.
And it was probably 2-3 o'clock in the morning. And they were like, whoop, whoop. They were still going. Everything was great. And I was awake and present, but I was not drunk like he was.
Yeah.
But I was just like, you know, I'm getting tired, but I'm cool. I'm having a good time.
I'm not going to stop them from having fun.
Well, not like that, but casinos, you have no idea what time it is.
That's
it's
true.
So it can be really fun. So we were at this really cool lounge. We were having cocktails and it was really a great time. And then Daryl just stands up in the middle of it and he just looks at me. And he has ceased to speak. He can no longer speak.
Oh, God.
And he
I've
starts.
Had that happen to me.
He's pointing to the elevator. And I go, oh, I go, are you done? And he just goes, and he just points to the elevator and he starts walking. I'm like, I turn to his dad. I go, I guess we're done. Good night. He's like, good night.
Well, maybe, you know, have you ever gotten like that before where all
no.
of a sudden you're spinning and everything? You're like, I am so fucked up.
I usually have verbal skills. I've never seen Daryl not be able to talk. He was so drunk.
I'm trying to think of yeah.
He doesn't remember anything.
I have not done that in a really, really long time,
yeah.
But I will confess that I like okay, maybe 10 years I hadn't done it.
Yeah.
And then I did it last summer.
Oh, really?
But I wasn't nonverbal.
Yeah, he was nonverbal. I'm like, I've never seen
this
before.
I disappeared. I basically
you blacked out.
No, I knew I was to that point where I'm like, this is not going to end well for me.
Yes.
And I haven't done this in a really long time. And in my old age, I've gotten so paranoid about dying or doing something really stupid.
I don't want to die dumbly.
Right? Because
I
of
don't.
Some stupid mistake I made.
I would
or
be
some,
so mad.
Yeah, some poor judgment that I did, you know.
Right.
So when I feel so incredibly out of control like that, mm-hmm. I get kind of paranoid.
You just go, ah.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, fuck. Well, and then I know there's nothing I can do about it.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? Because when you're old enough to realize how alcohol affects your body and everything, you're like, okay, there's literally nothing I can do.
But time.
But wait. Yeah. Yeah, and drink as much water as I can get in my body.
Yes.
And so I literally, everybody was doing their own thing. You know, I think what it was is that I didn't drive that day.
Oh, so you felt free.
So, and I don't know if anyone else does this, but when we travel on road trips, when we stop for gas or whatever, or yeah, we stop to get snacks, I will take little sneak-a-tokes. Like, I will take a little shot, or I will make myself a little mini cocktail and drink it in the back.
If you're not driving.
I wasn't driving. I don't do it while we're driving because it's illegal, but
sure.
I will pop the trunk or whatever and, like, do
just
that.
Be like, cheers!
To myself, yeah. Yes. So Jerry's like, God, you did that a lot on our way here.
Oh.
And I was like, oh, did I? He's like, yeah. And so by the time we got to the room, I was already fucking shit-faced. So, and then, of course, I set up a little bar when we get in the room and everything. So, I mean, I all of a sudden was, like, looking around. And I was like, oh, my God, I'm fucking hammered. And it's, like, 6 o'clock
in the evening. Oh, I hate
I'm so screwed. Yeah.
I hate it when I do that.
So, I ended up just, like, they were doing their thing. And I just, like, snuck off. And I went to the bathroom, shut the door, locked it. And then, like, about an hour later, Jerry's like, hello? And I'm
that's
like,
happened to me. I was like, you know what? I got that drunk when
it was terrible.
I got that drunk when Paula had her bachelorette party many, many years ago. We all went to that Folsom club and we all just got really, really drunk.
We went to Folsom?
Yeah, we went to like the Powerhouse pub or something like that. And I got really, really hammered and I ended up in her bathroom with the door locked. And Victor was like, Jamie, are you all right? I'm like, leave me alone. I was
get
like,
out. I know.
I went to a very dark place that night.
Oh, yeah.
It was weird. It was so weird.
I hate it.
I had not been that dark before.
It's not fun. It's like, it really screws things up.
In fact, when that happened, you're like, that's it. I'm done. Never again.
Yeah. I mean, it was a really good reminder of why I didn't let that happen to myself in a really long time. I'm like, oh my God, I'm never doing that again.
It just sucks because when you're doing it, you're like, I'm having such a good time. I feel so good.
Yeah.
And then suddenly reality
and then you're
slaps
not.
You in the head and you're like, oops.
Yeah. Your body's like, okay, that's enough.
I think we need
to purge.
Yes. God. Purge the demons.
The worst.
Okay.
Yeah.
So speaking of traveling, you went on a mini vacay with your fam. And you went to the Bay Area.
We did an RV. We went to San Francisco.
You did not RV. Oh, my God. If you told me that, I'd be like, I don't believe you.
I know, right?
I still
secretly kind of want to do it. I'm not going to lie. I don't know why. Maybe I just, it's like an itch I need to scratch.
Maybe
like,
they have special, like, reinforced locks that you can buy and, like, add it to the middle so they can't come in.
I mean, I think a lot of it's going to have to do with what RV park we go to.
Sure.
There's kind of like...
There's some nice ones.
Rich ones. Like where does that sound snobby?
No.
I want to go where the rich people are, but yeah, kind of.
Well, you don't want to go where people go for seasonal work. You want to go where...
Where they accept homeless people. So I started getting familiar with them. I'm like, I like the ones that, you know, your RV can't be older than like 10 years.
Oh, I didn't know
that. So they have to be new.
Like
yeah, yeah.
Oh,
so I like those. So,
cool.
Yeah, because I don't want any homeless people.
So you're going to give us a hotel review today. What hotel did you stay at?
So we stayed at the Argonaut Hotel. It's considered a boutique hotel, which is kind of not really my thing. It's in San Francisco.
Okay.
It's right on where the wharf is in Pier 39.
Yes.
But it's there's a tall ship museum. Have you ever seen it? With those big, huge, they're like pirate ships.
Yes.
Okay, so they're docked, so it literally faces that section right there.
So you have
can
a good
see,
view.
Yep. To your left is the Golden Gate Bridge.
Oh,
to your right
Walt
is
Disney
Alcatraz.
Museum is over there.
I think so.
It is.
I've just never been to that, but I've heard about
it. It's
literally like a block from Ghirardelli Square. One thing I loved about this hotel specifically is it had the really thick wood shutters on the
like
doors.
Plantation.
Yeah, like the really nice ones.
Yes.
And the windows actually freaking opened.
Oh, I love that.
Like, you could open every window, and there were so many windows.
I love
like
it.
Like, tons and tons of windows.
I do love it when they especially if you're on a higher floor, because I know why they don't do it, you know.
They didn't open all the way. You couldn't fall out.
No.
Although, Jeff got close to it, and I was like, Jeff, oh my God! I was like, don't go near that. Jerry's like, yes, you can slip right through here. You're so skinny. He's like, don't. So, yeah, Jeff was not allowed to go near the windows.
But I do like it when hotels allow you to have fresh air.
Especially in San Francisco.
Oh, God.
Because it
so
constantly
great.
Breezes there.
It smells so good.
It does. And we were since we were, like, right by the wharf.
Yes.
Holy shit. All we smelled was clam chowder, like, every minute.
Oh, my God.
And steaks and Steve, I mean, ScoMa's is
like are
you
hungry?
You can throw a rock at ScoMa's.
Oh, okay.
Which is a really, really nice
it is
restaurant.
Fun.
It's one of the better seafood restaurants in the city.
Cool.
So anyway, we had a fabulous time.
You stay there again?
Oh, heck yeah. It was definitely not our first time. We'd stayed there before.
Oh, okay,
it's just,
cool.
It had been, We didn't realize how long it had been. They reminded us, it's been 5 years since you've been here. I'm like, it's been 5 years? I'm like, oh my God.
Well, do you still give it 5 stars? Or do you have, any complaints?
The only thing I would say, and the thing is I'm trying to give them a break because pandemic is still in full swing. Yes. I think everybody's doing their best to get back to what the new normal is.
Yes, absolutely.
The restaurant could absolutely use a good manager.
Oh.
They're not doing room service right now, which completely sucks ass.
Why?
I don't know.
That's weird.
I don't know.
It's actually better.
I mean, they had full bell service and valet and all of that. And,
just no room service?
You know, the bell guy came into the room and all that. So I didn't get why they couldn't do room service, other than maybe it's a staffing issue, because I'm hearing restaurants are really struggling.
They can't find people
to work. Yeah, well, that's because the government's giving us all money, every 5 minutes, which I'm not complaining. I'm just saying, you know.
But they're making more money staying home.
Yeah, I mean, if you're on an unemployment and you're getting stimulus checks, you're making more than you would if you worked at a restaurant.
So there'll be a huge flux in September.
Same. So, yes, we had a great time. Yes, I will give them a break on the restaurant because I did have to go down and get the food to go. It was like an elevator ride. And
I know.
I'm such a snob. I'm like,
that's what I'm saying. I'm like, what?
Why? I know, right? Like,
what, they couldn't pay someone because to come up and bring it to you?
Right. Jesus. I know. Well, we even freaking DoorDashed while we were there. I was like, I'm not doing that twice.
Because you know DoorDash will bring it to your door.
They did. They came. That's hilarious. Let them, the front desk called and they're like, may we send up your DoorDash? I'm like, please do.
Thank you. And by the way, they're hiring, so maybe you could go down and...
Yeah, so we did.
Bring my coffee tomorrow morning.
We did that. God. It was fun. Actually, you know what? I have to say, and I wasn't sure what to expect in the city, but DoorDash and all of that stuff is so popular.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they were there in like 5 minutes.
Yeah,
I was like, why can't it be like this at home?
Because we have a bunch of...
Say it.
Which is a bunch of slobby people that do it.
Right.
I mean, it's just...
These are like professional people
this is their job.
Like what they do.
Yes, and they make very good money because they're very good at it. Where here it's just like, well, I thought I'd make an extra $20 for Christmas. Right. You know? And it's like, God, you fucking non-committal assholes.
Yeah, no, it was very... You know, that was the awesome thing about it. It was like totally packaged perfect. Everything was hot.
You know what? And it's only here. I've never... You know, I have come across a couple... But like one time somebody dropped something off and I don't remember which delivery company it was. And it was in the height of the pandemic. So, I mean, everybody's using everything.
Right.
And so I thought, you know, it'd get better. It'll get better. Too. So somebody drops off our DoorDash because now you don't touch anything. They literally drop it off and walk away.
Love it. And I'm all about it because I hate people.
Me too.
Oh my God.
I grab the bag.
I hate the ones who knock on my door. I'm like, contactless. What does that mean to you? Don't knock on my goddamn door. I'm sitting here watching you with my camera anyway, waiting for you to leave.
Right? So I grab the bag, I open it up, and it's not the right order, and there's no drinks. And now, I normally don't order drinks, but they just come with it.
Right.
And so I run out to the driveway, because I'm like, it will be a fucking Megillah to get
totally
it.
It totally is.
So I run out into the driveway, I'm like, hey, 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 and... It's a woman with a child in her car.
Oh,
and
Lord.
She's freaking out. And she's like, speaks zero English.
Oh, for God's sake.
And I'm just like, this is the wrong order. And she's like, what? I'm like, my order's missing. This is like two of the things. And there's no drinks. There's no fries. Like, whatever. And she's like, oh. So the little boy looks down and it's sitting between his feet on the floor.
Oh, my God.
And so he picks it up and he comes out and he gives it to me. And I'm just like, you know, if I was somebody else, this would be really bad. Because a little boy coming out. I mean, what are you going to do if I'm some monster?
Right?
I would never do that. And I'm just like, well, you are.
I would never bring my child with me. But I mean, maybe she's desperate.
Yeah,
maybe
which is totally really fine. I mean, it's not about that. But it was just like, that is the level. Because apparently we don't have professional DoorDash people here.
God.
You know, so it's people like that. So it's not good.
Right.
It isn't good. Well, I mean, okay. No judgment, everyone. I'm just saying this story. So we used it. Last summer, and this person could not find our house.
Oh.
45 minutes, and he's around the corner, and he could not figure out how.
Did he call you?
Excessively. We were literally talking
to
them.
Like, go right. Do you see that thing right there?
He's walking him through it.
Why didn't he just like, I'll walk to AMPM. Meet me there.
So he goes, well, I'm in this roundabout. He goes, okay, you are in my neighborhood. I am walking out and I'm going to see you and I'm going to wave at you and you're going to give me the food. And he goes, okay.
So that would end up happening?
He's driving around in circles and Daryl walks out to the mailbox to the
yeah, yeah.
Where he is. The guy gets out. He's a little person.
Sorry. Oh, my God. Here's the thing, though. We just have a we don't have anything against little people.
No.
But there were some jokes back in the day when we were little.
Yes.
And so that's why I laughed.
So little person.
It's like a thing for us.
I don't even know if that's the right word. I have been schooled by Paula many times. I know we can't call them midgets and stuff like that.
Oh,
but
really?
No. I think it's little person. I'm pretty sure it's little person.
Or so small person?
I don't know.
So Okay, go.
He gets out of the car and he's like, hey, sorry. Well, it takes Daryl by surprise because he wasn't expecting it. So he hands him the food.
And by the way, Daryl's like the
nicest person.
Sweetest, nicest person
so
on the planet.
So he takes the bag and he's like, I'm so sorry, da 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 da. And, you know, we...
I would have paid money to see this.
And
oh my God.
So I'm so angry at this point. I'm like, I'm going out there with you. And I should have. And I didn't.
Oh, that would have been so funny.
So he comes in and he's like,
Was he really laughing?
Yes. He goes, I really wish that you had come out with me. And I'm like, why? He goes, well, our friend was a little person. I'm like, wait, what? He goes, yeah. And I go, that's so weird. He goes, I know, because we were just talking about how I've never seen one in real life.
Oh, Daryl hasn't?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you haven't?
No.
Oh, I believe I have. I was trying to think. I'm like, I'm pretty sure I have.
And I said, no. And I said, I don't even know why it came up, but I said, no, I've never seen one. Like, I've never seen someone with that condition in
real
life.
Right.
And he's like, well, I really wish you'd come out with me. And he was all serious. And I'm like, why? He goes, well, he was a little person. And I'm like, what? I go, are you serious? He's like, yeah.
So, well, you weren't mad anymore, though, huh?
I wasn't. I was not mad.
I don't know why that's so funny.
Enjoy your cold burger. It was worth it. It was just crazy.
God, so
it was crazy. And then I'm like, man, this pandemic, huh? It's like, what's he gonna do?
It's so funny to me. I don't know why. It just makes
me
insane. Cry.
Because it was insane.
Well, it's like I can almost imagine Daryl's face.
Well,
I'm sure he didn't like.
No, he was fine with the guy. I mean, we don't.
No.
It's nothing like
Jamie.
That.
Jamie. Okay, I'm sorry. He's probably gonna have to edit this out.
No,
I'm sounding mean, but
no,
I just.
No, you're not. No,
it's funny. Just hell to me. Oh my God.
But
I guess I'm putting myself in his shoes.
Well, yeah, I'm
because
just
I get really pissed about shit like this.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Then
he's like, well,
ready to confront somebody, and all of a sudden he comes out. He's like 2 feet tall. I'm like, oh.
Well, that's what he said, and that was the other thing he said. He goes, and he was like a really little person. Like, he was really, really short. And I was like,
he was extra small.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes, he was.
Daryl's going to be like, you guys are too much. Stop it.
No. It's just the life. It's life. It happened. For real. It happened.
I know.
Well, what was weird is, explain to me why I mentioned to him, I've never seen one before. Like, what was that? Was that? I don't even remember. He's like, you literally just said you've never seen a little person in real life. I'm like, why would I say that?
Like, you wanted to. Like, that's on my bucket list.
God, it was so funny. Oh my God.
Oh my God. I can't.
Oh my God. Oh,
God, that's hilarious. When was this? This was not that long ago,
right? It
was
like in the winter. It was like 6 months ago, maybe?
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
But anyway, yeah, so DoorDash is weird here. It's not like the city.
Clearly.
So, I'm sorry. I'm just so glad you guys have good service.
Oh, my God. You know what's so funny about that story is literally yesterday was one of those days. I told you that I was sick, okay, right?
I had
not been feeling well. I'm sitting on the couch. I'm flipping channels, feeling sorry for myself.
Yeah.
With a blanket, not doing crap, letting my house fall apart around me. And I come across this movie that I don't know why the hell I stopped on it. It was the very beginning of it. It's called Downsizing. Have you seen it with Matt Damon?
Yes, I have seen it.
It's about becoming small.
It is. It's about they shrink themselves and live in these little terrariums.
Yeah. So
it's a terrible movie.
Watching it. And then Jerry comes home from work while I'm watching it. He's like, and I'm laughing. He's like, what? I'm like, this movie is so fucking weird. He's like, what?
It's so awful that you can't help it.
I had to watch it.
Stephanie, I watched the whole thing from beginning to
end.
In
fact, I had to go do, I had to go to Walgreens to retrieve more feminine products. And I literally was like, oh, wait, but I want to see what's going to happen on this movie. So recorded it. And I'm like, record.
I know. I've done
that
before.
So when I came home, I rewound it where it was and I watched it and I was like.
I think I watched that on a plane.
It was very odd. God. Oh, yeah, I could see that.
It was weird.
That would be a movie to watch on a plane.
Yeah, I was just like, my mouth was open the whole time. I'm like, what is this?
Well, I can't. And then I'm trying to predict the ending. I'm like, how is this going to end?
I know.
The whole movie was very bizarre.
It is bizarre. I assume that someone did this when they were on mushrooms somewhere, ayahuasca or something.
Or something. Jerry was like, God, is this movie ancient or something? So he looked at it, he's like, 2017? He's like, this is kind of new. I was like, I know, right? It's so weird.
Yeah, it got really shitty reviews. Okay.
It was stupid, but.
So speaking of shitty reviews, I have to talk about this. Okay, so California loves to recall their governors. They love it. They love to, you know, say, we're sick of your pretty face, Gavin. And then they're going to recall him. They did it to Jerry Brown. They've done it a million times. So now we're in the midst of a potential recall vote in, I think, November, whenever it is, with Newsom. Yeah. Because they hate his face for going to French Laundry. But by the way, if you could go to French Laundry, you wouldn't hate his face. I'm just saying. It's an amazing experience. I understand. It was horrible. It was a bad look.
I think, from what I've heard, the majority of the criticism he's getting is the pandemic.
Of course. Like I said, I was telling somebody this. There's not one governor in this country that is going to come out of this smelling good. No one's going to think anybody handled it well. So whatever.
True.
Anyway, so today I come to find out that Caitlyn Jenner has decided she's running for governor.
I saw that.
And I'm like, are you fucking insane?
Yes.
Have we learned nothing? God, nobody wants another goddamn reality star in the governorship of all things.
No one's going to elect Caitlyn Jenner as the governor. I think she's doing it for publicity.
That's what I thought, too. Here's the problem that I have with this. I want to say that I believe that no one would elect Caitlyn Jenner to governorship.
That's true, but they did elect Trump.
But here's the deal. Trump did his whole thing wasn't to win. It was all marketing. He had a ton of other plans. They had to scramble when he won. They're like, holy shit, we have to assemble.
To be the real president now. Oh my God.
Right? And so, you know, let's not act like we're not the biggest idiots on the planet and wouldn't elect Caitlyn Jenner.
That's true.
So I'm like, Republicans, really? Really? This is it? This is what you got? Come on, man. This is why I'm an independent, by the way. Well, I hate everybody.
Right?
I don't want anybody to do... I can't stand it.
Well, I hate Caitlyn Jenner for a lot of reasons, and none of them are political.
Oh, for sure.
I hate the way she treated her family.
I hate
the way she treated her wife at the time.
A lot of deception, a lot of lies. Oh, maybe they're perfect for politics. Who knows? But I seriously don't know how serious she is about it.
I think she's serious, but I think she's doing it more for the PR. I don't think she...
I had to really wrestle with it because I'm like, why am I so angry at this? I'm angry at this because I feel like it's a joke.
Yeah.
And can we stop making a joke about... politics,
about our political offices.
Like, it has real consequences. And it,
absolutely.
I mean, have we not learned anything?
Right?
So it's like, can we stop doing that, please, and just get back to boring people and just, you know, lawyers?
People who are just
lawyers and people who really love that stuff.
Who know the law and study the law and live for it. And
God,
all that
I would
stuff.
Love it.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree.
Anyway, all right. Well, speaking of awkward moments, let's do some ugly and awkward moments of the week.
God. Well, mine's alone, and so I let my roots... Okay, I have blonde hair. Everybody knows that, and it's not natural.
No.
It hasn't been for 25 years.
I don't know too many people who are naturally blonde.
Not as blonde as we are, but so I was letting my roots grow out because I was going to go to your hair guy.
Yes.
And it's been on my list, but the thing is your hair guy is really busy, so I knew I wasn't going to get an appointment for probably at minimum a week out from the time that I called.
He's really booked out now.
Right, maybe even longer.
Yeah.
That's been, like, deterring me from calling him because I work, and I knew I was going out of town, and I'm like, God, I just can't get the stars to align for me to be able to ensure that when I do get an appointment with him that I can make it, you know? And so I finally was so sick of it. I literally had like four different kinds of blonde box blondes because I kept buying them.
Oh,
different
you're like,
ones.
Maybe I'll just do it.
Well, I'm like, you know what? If I get desperate enough, I'll do it. And I'm always, because you cannot really do a good job on blonde with a box. You can, but I mean, it's I've been doing it so long that I probably do it better than most. But I'm also aware that it's never that great, and that if you get the wrong one or you haven't used it before,
you'll
you can really
orange.
Fuck your hair up bad. Yeah. So I had been doing tons of Google research to see if I could find one that would work until I could get to the salon. And I finally found one that I was pretty confident. I'm like, this shit is strong. Because that's the thing is, like, it's not strong enough.
Yeah, you need bleach.
You
like,
really
real
do.
Bleach.
Yeah, yes. So this one had bleach in it. It was actual bleach. It had the powder shit, you know, the whole thing. So I did it, and I'm always so terrified because of all, in all the years that I've been doing my hair, I have burned my hair off completely once.
Really?
Yes. To where it was a bob.
Oh my God.
It was at my chin. Okay. My hair is past my boobs. Like, it's long.
Oh my God. I would have started crying.
And what had happened was, is we had moved and I wanted to do my hair blonde again because the place that we moved from had well water and it was so bad that I could not have blonde hair when I lived there because my hair was bright orange. So once we moved, I was so excited.
You're like, I'm getting my hair blonde.
Yes. I was like, we finally lived in a normal house with water. And I, but I knew I had to wait because there was so much mineral deposits on my hair. And I was getting impatient. So what I ended up doing is I ended up buying some Sun-In. And I was just very lightly streaking my hair with Sun-In in a blow dryer just to start like lightening it up. And I was like, oh, I'm starting to feel like myself again. You know, well, I did this for about a month. And then I finally was like, okay, I'm done waiting. I can't wait anymore. I went and bought the shit that I knew how to use. I brought it home. I put it on my hair. And when I was rinsing my hair in the shower, it was just falling off. I felt like a chemo patient.
I would have absolutely lost it.
I was literally crying in the shower. I was like, no. I mean, yes, it was that feeling where you're
scared. I would have had a full-on anxiety attack.
I did. And like, I was like,
what did I do?
I mean, I knew what was happening. Yeah. And I'm like, I was literally like, am I going to be bald? You know, I was like, am I going to be bald? You know, am I going to have bald spots? And then I'm like, what am I going to do? You know, like, I'm going to be wearing hats. You know, I'm like, I didn't know there was nothing else to do.
I guess I'll be the beanie mom.
So, I'd never wanted to experience that again. No. So when I do my own hair, I'm very, very careful.
Yeah.
And I wait a long time in between before I do it. They say wait 6 weeks. I usually wait 8.
Yeah.
And I'm very gentle and I never overprocess it. So with this stuff, since I had never used it and it was real bleach, I was very cautious.
Yes.
I'm like, the last thing I need, because my hair is already blonde and I was really just doing the roots, I'm like, I don't want it to overlap into the blonde part and break right there. Because then my hair would be like an inch long. 2 inches long.
You would look like a Barbie doll.
Yes, and I was so scared of that.
Yes.
So I finally did it, and I let it process just slightly longer than it says to, like maybe 5 minutes. Washed it off, was all, you know, when you do your own hair, you don't see what you look like right away because you're in the shower.
Your hair's foggy.
And you're just like, you know, you almost forget, you know.
You're like, oh, that feels so good to get all that out.
Yeah, it felt so good to get it off my head. The conditioner that it comes with is amazing.
Oh, good.
Your hair feels like super soft. And so I get out and I'm towel drying myself off. Finally get the mirror clear and I look and I'm like, oh, fuck. I looked like Big Bird.
Oh,
and it was wet.
Are you kidding?
No, and my hair was wet. I was like,
you don't look like that now, so that's why I'm like, what?
This was 2 weeks ago.
Oh, okay.
2 weeks tomorrow.
Did you wear scarves or turbans to
work? No. Thankfully, I've been doing this long enough that I had pre-prepared for the potential that this might happen.
Did you buy like a toner or something?
I bought a really strong purple shampoo and conditioner set.
So
I paid
like a toner.
$60. They were like six ounces each.
So it was a toner. Okay.
Yes. So, and I had it. I had already had it.
Thank God.
I was so grateful that I had that, Jamie. So the true test is always when I come out after I've blow dried to see what my family's going to say.
And they're like, wow.
Well, I mean, Jerry and I have been together for so long. It'll be, I believe it's going to be 24 years this month in April.
Yes.
And so he's brutally honest.
He'll be like, what the fuck did you do to your hair?
No, he won't usually have that kind of reaction, but he'll say something funny. So I did it. I blow dried it. I looked at it. I was like, yeah, this is not good. Like, this is really bad. Like, I was like, oh my God. I'm like, oh my God. And I always do my hair on a Saturday because then it gives me Sunday to fix it. Because I did that once. And guess what? I had the meeting of my fucking life on Monday.
Oh no.
And I was bright as a fucking Easter egg and everybody was staring at me. I know it. I put my hair in a bun. Like, I did everything I could.
And they're just like, wow.
But it was just, it was horrendous. It was horrific.
Well, what did he say?
So I walk out and he's just like, they call me Mellow Yellow. Started singing.
Great.
And I was like, shut up. I was so embarrassed. But I mean, I'm like, fuck it. You know what?
It looks like
it is what it is. Oh my God. So I've been soaking my hair in purple conditioner and shampoo for 2 weeks. And it is quite the commitment, let me tell you. Because I can't stand being in the shower for like 45 minutes.
Oh, no, that would drive me insane.
It makes me crazy.
Well, why do you have to do it in there?
Because the kind of stuff, the stuff that you're supposed to leave it on. The minimum is 5 minutes.
Oh, you probably leave it on.
But the maximum is like if your hair is really fucked up, double it. So it's like 10. And that's per product. So you have to do the shampoo first.
Yeah.
And this stuff is so purple. Black purple that you have to wear gloves.
Oh, Jesus.
Because it stains your skin. It's so dark.
What's it called?
I've never heard of it before, but I got it on Amazon.
I'm really glad you got it.
It was really expensive, and it has cured me for the most part, but it's still fucked up.
Well, I didn't notice anything when you came in. You're like, don't look at my hair.
Well,
like,
my friend, when Veronica saw me before it was this, I got it to this point, and she's like, I said the same thing to her. I was like, shut up. Don't laugh at me when you look at my hair. She's like, what? I don't know. Oh, my God. Yes, I do. All right, I see it. I was like, shut up. She's like, oh, so God, funny. What'd you do? I was like,
it looks pretty good to me. I mean, I know you're probably just like, I hate it.
I do hate it.
It's
but
your hair. So, I mean, I get it. I totally understand.
I'm just going to wait maybe another week, and then I'm going to do it again. I just didn't want to do it too close to when I did it, because I don't want to burn my hair off.
Oh, no.
But I was even like, okay, can I call Greg? I'm like, I don't even want him to see me like this. He'll be like, what the fuck did you do, you moron?
Oh, well, I mean, I was telling you some stories. I'm telling you that he probably has seen a lot of mess.
Yeah.
No problem. Well, mine is not nearly as dramatic as yours.
God.
So the other day, I mean, before we close the show, I'm going to tell you something, and then we're going to close the show after my awkward moment. But the other day, I was talking to Daryl about something, and as I told you, and we talked about a little bit on last week when you were on vacation, that Daryl and I are intermittent fasting right now.
Yes.
And so
I was like, wait, what?
I'm drinking copious amounts of water. Amounts of water.
I hear that's actually really a really great way to lose
weight.
First
of all,
fast.
My skin has never looked better.
Wow.
And second, I haven't lost shit weight yet, but they say it takes 3 weeks. So it's only been 2.5. So, we'll see. But I'm hoping, we'll see. I mean, I'm not trying to lose
a ton. So when you fast, like, does that mean you literally eat no food? And for how long?
Well, I'm doing an 18-hour fast. So 18 hours and then 6 hours of eating. And so basically, you have to eat healthy. You can't eat, just can't power load, for 6 hours or anything, or you're just not going to lose any weight.
Carbs and
right.
all that,
And really, it has not been hard. I actually realized that I was kind of doing it already, but the problem is that I love to snack all day.
Right, same.
And so I'm a grazer, so when it's time for meals, I'm just not that hungry, but I'll eat meals too, so I'm like, okay.
Or you eat some of it.
Right, and so basically, it's cured me of my habit of grazing all day.
Yeah.
I definitely have noticed changes, but,
So when you feel hungry, do you just drink a glass of water?
I drink water, and if I'm still hungry, I'll be like, okay, I can't wait for this fast to end. But it doesn't really happen that often.
Yeah.
The water tends to cure it, and so, because you're just really thirsty.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that's important because I'm walking around with my flask all the time. I'm drinking water.
Your flask?
Yeah, oh, your water. I have a big water flask. Right. Yeah, my hydro flask all the time. And so I was talking to her and I said, okay, I need to go up and get upstairs. I need to shower. It's getting late, in the day.
Yeah.
So I have my flask, my phone, my glasses, some other shit, and I'm running up the stairs.
Oh, no.
In socks.
I was about to say, did you have socks on?
And I slipped. And I fell hard on my knees. And I clung to all the
shorts?
No, I was wearing leggings. And I clung to all the things. And when I landed hard on my knees, I peed my pants. I had to pee so bad.
Well, I can't hold shit anyway.
Because I was trying so hard to get upstairs, pee, shower. And I'm just trying
to
multitask. Oh, my
God, that is so funny. And, of course, Daryl.
He didn't hear a thing because he had earphones on because he was on a call. So I'm like, kunk, like that. I was like, oh, my shit, I peed. And I was like, God damn it. So then I'm like getting up and I'm waddling.
You're like, I can't get these clothes off fast enough.
I could not. I'm like, I should just throw these away.
Honestly, right?
I hate it so much. I haven't done that in so long.
Well, I mean, we've had children. And we've never had good bladders.
Gotta do the Kegels.
Honest to God. But I mean, we've had bad bladders from since birth.
I'm just, the thing is like I watch TikTok videos and there's so many videos of women tripping and falling on their way to their cars. And it makes me laugh hysterically.
I would do it.
Because it's me. I've done it.
Yeah. I was like, I have so many random bruises on me that I don't even know. I'm like, I think I vaguely remember like, ouch, damn it. But it happens so frequently that they don't stick in my mind.
I walked through the door the other day and I missed it and literally smacked my whole arm.
Oh my God.
It's still sore. And Gerald's like, you all right? I'm like, I don't know. Apparently I can't go through a five foot wide door without hitting something.
And I get so angry. Like so damn angry because I'm like, why do I do this shit? Like,
idiot woman.
I know.
I hate it.
I could run it, trip on a piece of dust. I'm like, I just don't understand.
So true.
Why it's so hard for me to get through this life.
I agree. Okay, and then finally, I'm not going to get into why I saw my dentist, but I did see my dentist yesterday.
Oh, God. Jesus. Okay, there's been 3 whole weeks.
There's an issue, and so I had to go back. Come to find out, my dentist has retired.
Oh, no.
Dr. React retired.
He didn't tell you?
So I called and I said, hey, there's kind of an issue with this root canal he did and I just need him to look at it. Can I make an appointment? And, you know, I'm going to be going on vacation and I don't want to deal with this, you know, when I'm on vacation. Yeah. And she's like, you're in luck. He's in today. And I'm like, okay. And I didn't think anything of it because, you know, they kind of switch hours because of the pandemic. And I said, okay, great. So I come in and he's retired. Today, yesterday was his last day of work.
Oh.
Like forever. And so his staff is crying. Everyone just had, the final meeting.
Is this like a practice meeting where he has like multiple dentists and so it'll keep being open, but he just won't be there?
He hired someone to take over his practice.
Oh, maybe he sold it.
He shares the office with 2 other people, but he actually had someone come and he's literally coming in and
so
taking over.
So most doctors are
like
dentists.
Like the staff is staying.
Yeah, yeah. Everything. I was about to say, most doctors are dentists. Their practice, including their staff and their clients, mm-hmm. they sell it.
Yeah, I don't know
because
if he sold
it's so valuable.
I mean, he probably did sell it, but
yeah, that's what happened to their friend. We have a couple friends that are doctors.
So
yeah.
Anyway, so finally, you know, so his staff is crying and they're like, we're really hoping there's something wrong with you, so he has to stay. And I'm like, well, okay.
I don't think he likes me that much, but okay.
Well, or does anyway, he? I think he likes me, yeah. Not like that. Maybe.
Yes, like that. Shut Maybe. Up. We've had these conversations about Dr. React before.
I'm just so madly in love with him smitten. For some reason. I don't know why.
Well, he's good looking. And
I
he's
think
smart.
It's because he's so smart. He's so smart. And he's a dentist. And he doesn't hurt me when I go in there. But anyway, so I sit down and he comes. He's like, hi, Jamie. Because he's such a nerd. He's like, hello.
And he's I like go, Ned hi. Flanders.
I go, so you're retired?
Like, and hello?
He's like, yeah. And I'm like, well, I guess congratulations are in order. I go, but when were you going to tell me? He goes, well, I was going to tell you. I'm like, when?
It's like, you're breaking up with me.
I go, this is the last day, and I just happened to call. I go,
I going to get a postcard in the mail everybody else?
In fact, Daryl, when I was leaving, he goes, aren't you glad that you called today? And I'm like, yes, I'm kind of devastated. I'm like, I don't really know how to handle this. I go, what, some stranger's going to be touching me in my mouth? I don't even know who this guy
right?
is.
Like,
I'm like, what the fuck? I'm being ghosted by my dentist?
Right?
So I go in.
It's huge.
And I said, I can't believe you weren't going to tell me. And you know me, we're all like this. I'm just like, I'm the most important person in the room. So I'm
For
like,
sure.
I'm like, I can't believe you weren't going to tell me. He's like, and below his breath, he's like, well, I was going to tell you. I'm like, really? I'm like, when? And I start I feel like a jilted lover. I'm like, when were you going to tell me? Here I am. And it just happened to be today that I decided to call you. I go, is someone else going to treat me on Thursday when I have to come back? He goes, no, I'm coming in. I will do it. And I'm like, what is going on? And so finally, we were talking.
Do you have a dentist chair in your garage so that when I have an emergency, I can come over?
So here's the irony, though. This is so bizarre. Okay, we actually had the same gynecologist for years together. You and I, we all did. He retired.
A long time ago.
I was his last patient.
How weird.
I was his last patient. He's like, well, you're the last vagina I'll ever see, you know.
Besides my wife's.
Oh, yeah, right. And so I was like, okay, well, congratulations,
That's so funny.
Dr. Marshall. Yeah. So anyway, I will be his last patient.
Aww.
Ever.
Like, you have a thing for that.
It's so crazy.
It's
Isn't
so
it
weird?
Weird? And I'm like, and I told you I came home and I said, do I get a gift? Like, do you give retiring your dentist gifts? Like, what do you do? Like,
yeah, I mean, how long have you been going to him?
15. I was 15.
Oh, so forever.
In fact, my Dr. React told me that I was one of his very first patients.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Is that crazy?
That is so crazy.
And I'm like, do I friend him on Facebook? I don't even know.
You could.
I asked him, are you going to do anything fun? I mean, are you going to travel? He goes, well, we might. And I'm like, well, what's your plan? You're just going to just retire and have no plan?
Jerry and I were friends with our insurance, our Allstate guy.
Aww.
and he retired, too.
It's so weird. And so then
everybody's retiring because we're getting old.
This really old, elderly woman, she must have been in her late 80s. She looked really cool, though. She kind of looked like grandma a little bit. And she comes in, she's like, so, Dr. React, I hear you're retired. Well, congratulations. Enjoy your life.
God.
And she's like, I know. And she just stuck her head in, you know. And he's like, well, thank you very much. And so I'm like, I can't believe this. I was just like out of my mind.
You have to continue working until I say you can't.
Right? And so the front office goes, well, he's finishing up all the cases, da, da, da.
Yeah.
So I was scheduled to go in at 2 o'clock next week to have him fix this tooth. And so she calls me back. I'm on my way. She goes, well, it is going, you are his very last patient of all time. So can you come in at 9? Because he, you know, wants to end the day.
So he doesn't have to, like, work all day. All day.
And I'm like, yeah, sure, of course. No problem. So I'm like, oh, my God. Isn't it weird?
So you haven't done it yet.
No, I have to go back. Okay. And I'm just
yeah,
like,
I don't know. You're going to have to think about it. You mean, you must know him. What does he do besides dentists?
Big golfer.
Yeah, well, of course.
But anyway.
Being a rich dentist, he probably has everything.
I know. But anyway, I'm just like, I can't believe it. I can't. It's an end of an era.
Oh, my God.
My fantasy's coming to a close.
Yeah, and I can't even go see him now because I was going to.
Well, he was very honest, and he said, this guy is really, really good. He goes, he's really good, Jamie. And I said, I don't care as long as you put in Sharpie on my file that says Jamie is very anxious and she needs a lot of Novocaine. I'm good.
Yeah.
That's it. And he's like, I will note it in your chart. I'm like, thank
Please
you.
Please do.
God.
And that you do give me Valium on occasion.
Yes. And that you're my pusher for Valium.
Yeah. Well, I mean.
Anyway. So, yeah. So, it's an end of an era. My crush on my dentist is coming to a close.
Boo.
I know. So that's okay, though. And I am very happy for him. I told him, I'm like, well, congratulations.
Honestly, you can't, how can you not be?
No, and he's not really super old. So, I mean, he's going to enjoy his life.
That's the thing about being a doctor or a dentist. That's one of those lovely things.
Yeah, he's going to travel. He's going to go visit in-laws and relatives and brothers.
He's probably going to do things he hasn't ever got to do, because that's the thing about those professions. They work so much.
I was thinking about it. I'm like, you're going to get to sleep in on a Wednesday?
Yes.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Oh, my God, I'm so jealous.
I know.
I'm going to be like 80 by the time I retire.
I know. So anyway, so congratulations, Dr. Yak. I know you don't listen, but I'm just saying.
Congratulations, yeah, but
you know, in another world, I would have stolen you. In another world, I would have stolen you away, but that's okay.
Right.
Anyway, all right, well, that's all of the show we have. I think that's plenty. All right, everybody. Bye, Lumi. We love you.
Bye.